Greetings everyone, welcome back to my channel Data Sculptor. Today we are going to solve a case study for social media data using SQL. So for that we have some two tables called posts and users. So in posts you have a few columns called post ID, user ID, content and creation time. So if you see, post ID is unique over here, and for one user ID you'll have multiple posts, because in social media if you are user, you can have multiple posts, and each of the posts you have some content and also some creation time. And second, users, you have the user IDs, first name, last name, and the join date. So our main agenda of this, or the aim of this particular video, is not to solve SQL. Instead, we'll see, we'll try to generate some insights out of this data. And how we'll generate some insights, we'll use SQL to generate some insights. So let's go back to SQL Server Studio and see what all insights we can generate. So as discussed, these are the two tables, posts and users, and posts and users have some data as shown earlier. And in the users table, user ID is the primary column. So the user ID is always unique. So one user will be having only one user ID. And in post table, post ID is the primary column. So for one post, for one user ID, there can be multiple posts. So here the question is, we need to find the number of posts, a number of users who are having posts. That means, so here if you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 users are there. And here the posts are for the all for this users. So user ID 1 has one post. Two post, user ID has two has some posts. So we need to find the number of user IDs who are having posts and number of user IDs who are not having any posts. So hope you all understood the question. So now let's see how to solve this. So first, select from post, sorry, users, A, left join, posts, B, on, A dot user ID is equal to B dot user ID. And if I write this, we'll get the combination of the users and the posts. So when I run this, this is what you're getting. All the user IDs, all the users are having posts, but user 7, Rob David, is not having any posts. Okay, so if you see, the number of persons who are not having any posts is 1, and the number of persons who are having posts is 6. So that should be the output. So first, to categorize the users, we have to do in this way. So first we'll write a case statement, case when B dot user ID is not null, then has posts, else no posts, and as status, okay, and comma ID. Sorry, and comma user ID. A dot user underscore ID. So when I write this, this is what we are getting. So has post and no post. Okay. So has post with all the user IDs and no post with the user IDs. So now from this data, we have to calculate the distinct users for each and every status. So what we have to do? Let's keep it in a CTE with CTE. As and select from CTE, here it is status comma count of distinct user ID, user underscore ID as user count, group by status. Okay, so when I run this, we'll get the number of users who are having posts and the number of users who are not having posts. So in this way, we'll have to calculate the number of users who are actively posting and the number of users who are not actively posting. Now we have seen the count of all the users who are actively posting and not actively posting. So now let's see the last three new users who have joined our social media. So to do this, we have to do simple select from posts, sorry, select from users. So select star from users, what are we getting? We are getting the user ID, first name, last name, and joined it. So what we'll do to find the last three new users, we have to do order by join underscore date, join underscore date in descending order. And if we do this, we'll get the users who are joined, the list of users from top to bottom who are joined as per the latest date. So if you see, these three are the new users because they have joined recently. I mean, in the, these are the three users who have joined us recently. So to get these three users name, we'll just write top three star. This will give us the last three new users for our system. And next question is, list the users who have made the most posts. So for this, we'll have to use simply join. Select from posts. Sorry, select from posts. A left join users. B on A dot user ID is equal to B dot user ID. And if we do this, we'll get simply the posts, simply the name of the, all the persons and the posts. So what we will do, we'll simply do B dot user ID, user underscore ID, comma count of post ID, post underscore ID as post count. And we'll keep this B dot user ID in the group by. And if we do this, we are getting user ID 1 and 2 having the most number of posts. Okay, so to do this, now this is the user IDs having the most number of, this is the count of user IDs having the users with each and every having the post counts. So what I will do, I'll keep this in a CTE with CTE as. Okay, so now for every user ID we have got the count. Now from this we have to find the maximum count. So select from CTE, which is max of post count as max post count. Okay, if we do this, we'll see, we'll get the maximum post count, which is 2. And now with this 2, we'll have to see, we have to return the users who are having this max post count. Okay, so I'll keep this in one more CTE, CTE 2 as again this, and select from CTE a inner join CTE to B on a dot post count is equal to B dot max post count, and here it is a dot user ID. And if I run this, we'll get the list of users who have made the most number of posts. This is one solution to find the users who have made the most number of posts. And second solution is, let's copy the same one, and let's keep it this way. And what we are getting, select star from CTE, right? And if we do this, we are getting these all post counts, right? So what we can do, let's try to create a dense rank. Dense rank. So dense rank, it will return the rank of all the posts, and just we'll filter out, we'll apply the filter rank, dense rank is equal to 1. So for that, I'll create a this one, dense rank over order by count of post underscore ID as rn. So now let's see if it's working or not. Okay, so yeah, here this is working. We can apply rank, we can apply the dense rank in the while doing the aggregation itself. So now but here we want it in descending order. right? So because we want to rank the users with the highest post first. So now if we run this, we are getting user IDs with the posts and the attendance rank for each and every user ID. And now simply I'll do where rn is equal to 1, and here it is simply user underscore ID. And now if I run this, we're getting the simply the user IDs 1, 2. So hope you all like this three questions. Even though it's simple one, I'm just trying to give you some case studies. So if you guys like this, I'll do more complex case studies in the coming videos. So if you like this, please click on the like button and also click on subscribe button for more videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.